Roshnidhar. Welcome to Medical Dialogues, a daily dose of health and medical news. Let's look at today's top news. Supreme Court assures mechanism for grievances redressal of overcharging by hospitals' doctors. Raid on Hetra Pharma Group. Income Tax Department detects rupees 550 crore hidden income, seizes rupees 142 crore cash. Maharashtra government rewards resident doctors with rupees 1.21 lakh each for their services in COVID-19 pandemic. Advisory by Ayush Ministry for refrain from use of ashwagandha. DCI issues measures for curbing menace of ragging in institutions. The Supreme Court on Friday said that it will devise a mechanism for redressal of grievances concerning overcharging of expenses by hospitals and doctors from COVID-19 patients during the second wave of the pandemic. A bench of Justice D.Y. Chandrachud and B.Y. Nagarathna, while issuing notice to the centre, said, "We will devise a mechanism to deal with such grievances." Advocate Krishna Balab Thakur, appearing for petitioner Abhinav Thapar, said that a lot of difficulties were faced by the patients during the pandemic as many hospitals and doctors overcharged them. Thapar in his plea has said that direction be issued to the centre to form a committee at the state and district level to scrutinise and audit the medical bills and the expenses overcharged from COVID-19 patients and their families. He also sought direction to the centre and state governments to direct the hospitals and doctors under their jurisdiction to refund the overcharged amount of such patients, or if they have died, then it should be paid to their nearest family member. The police said there is no uniform policy and guidelines till date regarding the refund of exorbitant amount overcharged from patients either at the state level or central level, and COVID-19 patients and their families are left at the mercy of private hospitals, which have been exploiting the global pandemic. The Income Tax Department detected unaccounted income of rupees 550 crore and seized over rupees 142 crore cash after it recently raided Hyderabad-based Hetro Pharmaceutical Group. Hetro shot into the limelight after the group signed several agreements and undertook development of various drugs such as Remdesivir and Favipiravir to treat COVID-19. It has over 25 manufacturing facilities located in India, China, Russia, Egypt, Mexico and Iran. The CBDT said the group is engaged in the business of manufacturing of intermediate APIs and formulations, and the majority of their products are exported to countries like the US, Dubai and some African and European countries. Various other legal issues were also identified, such as personal expenses being booked in the company's book and land purchased by related parties below government registration value. It alleged that the hideouts were identified during the raids, where a second set of books of accounts and cash were found. Incriminating evidence in the form of digital media, pen drives, documents, etc. have been found and seized, and digital evidence were gathered from SAP ERP software maintained by the SS Group. Further investigations and quantification of undisclosed income deducted are in progress. Acknowledging the services of resident doctors amid the COVID-19 pandemic, the Maharashtra government has recently issued a resolution announcing to give rupees 1.21 lakh to each of the resident doctors working in government, civic as well as government Ayurveda colleges. However, the government resolution has excluded the graduating batch of residents from this reward. Although the graduating doctors who have worked in the COVID wards for around 15 months have termed such a decision to exclude them from the allowance as unfair, the government officials have clarified that the allowance cannot be extended to everyone due to technical limitations. On the other hand, due to the delay in the conducting NEET PG examination, the first year PG students have not joined the college yet, so have technically not worked at all in the pandemic, said the doctor. Meanwhile, opining that government directives get applied prospectively and the GR has been issued after a lot of deliberations, an official reported to media. "We appreciate and are grateful for their contribution during the pandemic. We have held their work in high regard, but there are technical limitations. The directive will be effective from today and cannot be applied retrospectively." Ashwagandha, also known as Vithania somnifera or poison gooseberry, is a popular Ayurvedic herb often used in formulations prescribed for stress, strain, fatigue, pain, skin diseases, diabetes and arthritis. Recently, Ayush Ministry released a notice for ASU drug manufacturing companies to refrain use of Vithania somnifera or Ashwagandha. Vithania somnifera root is widely used drug in Ayurveda, Siddha and Unani systems of medicine since ancient period. Ayurvedic Parifomia of India defines that the Ashwagandha consists of dried mature roots of Vithania somnifera. As such, the use of leaves of Vithania somnifera has not been reported in classical texts of ASU systems of medicine. Some of the OTC formulations of Vithania somnifera leaves are available in markets, but neither their safety and efficacy is vividly studied nor reported in ASU classical text. No substantial evidence and literature is available to endorse the efficacy of crude drug extract of Vithania somnifera leaves. Considering the above and in the background of available textual evidence, it is advised that the manufacturers of the crude drug, ASU drug manufacturing companies and ASU drug exporters to refrain the use of Vithania somnifera leaves, either in crude or extract or any other form for the therapeutic purposes under the ambit of ASU drugs as per textual indications or as the food supplements in the name of ASU drugs. Aiming to ensure that no incident of ragging takes place in the dental institutions across the country, the Dental Council of India has recently written to the heads of all the dental colleges in India to strictly implement the measures for curbing the menace of ragging in their institutes. The implementation of directions of the Honorable Supreme Court of India regarding DCI regulations is to be uploaded on the DCI website by 31st October. As per the notice, the DCI has directed the following instructions to all the dental colleges of India. Section 11.3 of the aforesaid regulations, the authorities of the institutions, particularly the head of the institution, shall be responsible to ensure that no incident of ragging takes place in the institution. All dental institutions should issue advertisements against ragging through signboards, pamphlets, etc. All dental institutions shall designate any of the faculty members as counselor for fresher and senior students. Further requested to obtain and file undertaking on anti-ragging from all parents, guardians and students. It is also pertinent to mention here that as per section 12.1 of subject regulations, each and every institution shall submit its report in the prescribed format to the secretary. Further, it is also to inform you that the DCI has developed an online module to upload the requisite information documents on DCI website to reduce the paperwork. The Dental Council of India ensures zero tolerance against ragging of any sort. For more details, check the link below in the description box.
Never miss a medical update from Medical Dialogues. Like, subscribe, and press the bell icon.